Good morning, dear students. Today we will have our revision on two chapters, smart charts and long and short. See students, as I have already mentioned to you that you don't need to draw, it is not mandatory to draw the bar graph or the pictograph. But I will not discourage anyone who wants to draw them. If you want to draw them, you are always welcome. But if you are not drawing them, you can take the screenshot and send it along with the questions and answers so that it is easy for you to learn what you have solved for your future purpose. Now, the first question, observe the following bar graph and answer the following questions. Now, as you can see, there are a list of sports, 5 sports activities, and their marking or the number of students that are interested in each type of sport are given along the y-axis, that is the vertical line or the standing line, and the type of sports are given along the x-axis, that is the horizontal line or the sleeping line. Now, first question based upon this bar graph is, which is the most and least preferred sport? So, if there is only one choice which is most preferred, you will write most preferred sport is this, least preferred sport is this. Always maintain this thing. Do not write only the name of the sport, because it would be difficult for the examiner or the teacher while checking your copies which one you are answering. So please write down most preferred sport, put a dash, and what is the most preferred sport, write that. Then write down least preferred sport, put a dash, and then mention that particular sport. Number B, how many people prefer cricket to hockey? Now, whenever these things are to be done, as I have already mentioned to you, first thing to do is the listing of each of the items and their numbers. A 2-column chart mentioning the listing of the items and on the left hand side, and on the right hand side their numbers. This should be done. If you do these things, then it is very easier for you to compare or even add the total number of students or the children, whatever thing to be calculated, you can do that. Now, we move to the next page. Find the sum of people who prefer hockey, badminton and tennis. Now, for particularly question number C, what you will do, we come to the bar graph, hockey, badminton and tennis. So you can see that how many people like hockey, how many like badminton and how many like tennis. So you will add up the number of students of these 3 sports together and you will get a certain value. Now coming to question number D. The number of people who prefer cricket is dash times the people who like hockey. Now for this particular question, before moving into the bar graph, what you need to do, that listing I think you might have done, that listing should be done properly. If you have done the listing, then it is very easy for you to answer. But if you haven't done the listing, what will happen, every now and then you have to move to the bar graph for getting the answer. Now if we move here, you can find out how many people like hockey, and this is the number of people, how many students like hockey and how many students like cricket. Now then very easily you can get how many times the number of students are there who like cricket than hockey. Similarly, number of people who prefer football is dash times the people who like hockey. Again we move here. So number of people who like football is known to you, number of people who like hockey is known to you. Now you will write how many times is that. Okay, you can mention them under the fill up of these types, that this is the number of people who like hockey, this is the number of people who like cricket, and then find out what is the number of times. Because why I am asking you to do this thing, because it might happen that here the values are very simple, but sometimes the values are not so much simple, the values are a bit tough, and your comparison through only by observation is not possible. There you might need some calculations. For that purpose, I have mentioned you that please write down the value under the full statement of this fill up. Now coming to question number 2. Mr. Sundar had 75 cricket bats, 56 footballs and 35 tennis rackets in the beginning of January 2021. Now, from these number of values, we can have an idea that Mr. Sundar is a seller of sports equipments. He sells sports equipments. Okay. Now, at the end of January, that means at the beginning of January, he had such number of items, and at the end of January 2021, he had 39 cricket bats, 32 footballs, and 19 tennis rackets left. These are the quantities that are left, not used up. Please keep in mind while you are reading the question that these are the quantities of each item left after the month is over. Now you have to find the number of each item sold in the month of January 2021. You know what to do. Nothing more I should give the hint. You will very easily do this sum. But please don't forget to write the statement for each of the items. For each of the items, writing the statement showing the calculation is very necessary, because here the numbers are very less. I think somebody might do oral calculations even, but please try to make this habit that you show the calculation during your classwork. Now we come to a tally chart. This is question number 3. Now see that this tally chart is based upon the insects. Now suppose in a room or a home, these number of insects are seen or found, whatever it might be. So these are the insect scavenger tally chart. So here, as you can see, this is the ladybug. Its counting is given. Total here, the counting, how many are there. Ant, its counting are given. Butterfly and mosquitoes. Now you have to tell by comparing which insect is most and least available insect. So here you can find out which insect is found most and which insect is found least. So in this mode, just compare it in the chart and you can get the value. How many more ants are available than ladybug? So here also comparison based, you can very easily see how many more ants are available than ladybug. Number C, find the total number of insects in the tally chart. Whenever totaling is to be done, please add up all these values. Then you will get the total number of insects we are looking for. Now we come to question number 4. Now question number 4, you see the population of a town at the end of 1991 was 97,345, while the population at the end of 2001 was 1,34,602. Now, if you compare these two values, you can see that it has increased. You have to find the increase in the population. Every 10 year onwards, this thing is done. This is called census, counting the number of individuals. So you will find out what is the increase in the population. Again, comparison based, a topic of the long and short. Now we come to question number 5. Here again, a tally chart is given mentioning 4 different types of sports and the preferences of the students. So again, as I have told you, you might take the screenshot or you might draw the tally chart. It entirely depends upon you. Now for question number A, find the total number of students surveyed. Again, totaling here, this entire column you have to add and find out total number of students surveyed. And number B, find how many students prefer hockey to gymnastics. Now this is also comparison based. You have seen that how many students like hockey and how many like gymnastics. So based on this comparison, you can write down the answer very easily. So students, this would be published on Monday. So you just note it down whenever it's published in the school website, and then send it to the respective mathematics teacher of your section for checking. Okay, and please do remember that while you are sending the questions, your PDF set must contain the tally chart or bar graph wherever it is being supplied, the questions and the answers along with calculations wherever required. Okay, thank you.